the Scovell Scholarship Foundation, and the Cotton Bowl Athletic Association. Partners in Education present the legacy of Field and Mary Scovell, partners in life and education.
When I was a senior in high school, there were a lot of scholarships. I mean, I had two or three offers to go to school,
including one from Yale. But young Field Scovell, true to his roots, chose to stay in his native state and accept a scholarship offer from Texas A&M. There, he became part of the rich campus tradition, which included playing football for the Aggies and their legendary head coach, Dana X. Bible.
Coach Bible, of course, to me, was one of the finest men I ever knew, a great person. I was very fond of him.
He was also very fond of the man he knew as Coach Walker when he played for him at North Dallas High School.
We made some trips. We'd go to Plano and play a ball game or something like that. That's quite a trip. Coach Walker had a Franklin. Did you ever see a Franklin automobile? You're lucky. That dude would get hot. And we'd get about 12 miles out of town. We had to stop and sit a while, shoot the breeze, that baby cool off, then we'd start again.
Determined to make his own start after graduating from A&M, Field returned to his old high school and took up coaching himself. And he also ran a gas station, which, as it turned out, earned him quite the reputation.
Sitting there one night, and a guy came in and held me up. He said, "Just give me the bills." I remember, and I just gave him the bills, the cash register was there. And so he standing with his pistol in his hand. It was down in front of him, and he backed out the door and was standing there. And then when he hit the door, he started running. Well, I reached in and got this pistol. Some other people tell it funnier than I. I ran out the door, and I hit this driveway, and I started sliding, and I fired this gun twice. And there was a lady across the street going in her house, and I hit the shrubbery in front of her. I didn't come close to this guy. But stirred the neighborhood up anyhow.
But Field Scovell had only just begun to stir things up in his hometown, and it wasn't long before he found his true calling as a salesman, first for the nationally renowned Rawlings Sporting Goods Company, and eventually for the man who had a vision for Dallas like no one before. That vision became reality on January 1st, 1937, when J. Curtis Sanford declared the Cotton Bowl Classic open for business.
Sanford's the guy. Sanford had the idea. He was head of everybody. He came into this thing. It was his idea. He put the thing together, and a lot of people laughed at him, but he never did quit it. And I used to talk to him a lot, and I thought he was a pretty sharp guy. But he realized what I thought of it, and he would give me little jobs to do with this thing. I used to go see if there was soap in the showers out the Cotton Bowl and important things like that.
It was from those very humble beginnings that Field Scovell and the Cotton Bowl would become permanently linked, and it became his personal mission to make sure that the game Sanford started would not just endure, but that it would maintain its proud stature as a New Year's Day classic. A mission boosted substantially, he says, early on by one player, a player whose name will forever be associated with the Cotton Bowl, a Heisman winner from Dallas, who just happened to be the son of Field Scovell's old high school coach.
I think Dope could do about anything, and if he started something new, he'd pick it up. He was just a natural. It's like he could run with that football, he could kick it, he could catch it, do a lot of things. I think Dope's one of the best all-around football players I ever saw.
Today, it is mission accomplished. The AT&T Cotton Bowl Classic remains just one of four non-BCS bowl games to be broadcast to a national TV audience each year. And the trophy that is awarded to the game's champion honors the memory of the man who came to be known nationwide as Mr. Cotton Bowl.
I never have thought I've been underpaid in this spot, I guarantee you. I've gotten as much out of it as anybody has.
And how proud he would be today to see the bowl game that was so near and dear to his heart as it embarks on an exciting new era, and to know the tradition he helped establish of a game that is the envy of the entire college football world continues. But the enormous impact that Field Scovell had on his community is still felt to this day in so many other ways. He was part of a group that was responsible for bringing an NFL franchise to Dallas in 1960. He served on the Dallas School Board, and it was his passion for young people and education that led to the establishment of the Scovell Scholarship Foundation in 1991. The foundation awards thousands of dollars in scholarships to North Texas students with high moral character, leadership abilities, financial need, and a connection to sports. The scholarship winners are honored each spring at an awards reception at the Hyatt Regency, and then on New Year's Eve, they take center stage again at the AT&T Big Play Luncheon. The foundation has now awarded more than $600,000 to deserving students in North Texas. The Scovell Foundation Board is a volunteer-based organization that has taken on the challenge of raising funds to continually work toward increasing scholarships. In the end, 99% of all contributions go back to the student scholarships. The foundation, with the support of the Cotton Bowl Athletic Association, provides one more way to do what for Scovell became a way of life, giving back.
I've gotten a kick. I've been more than repaid. I've enjoyed it. I thought about it and seen what has happened with people that have benefited from something like this that I could have a little part of.
And even though he is no longer with us, his legacy lives on. The legacy of an honest, loyal, and humble servant.
I never have thought that I was such a big operator, that I did this or that. People said, told me how much I've done for Dallas. I never could repay Dallas what it's done for me. No, not any way.
It came as no surprise that the person who carried on Field's legacy and became a strident champion for the foundation's cause was his beloved wife of over 50 years. Mary Dupree Scovell carried the torch of the Scovell Scholarship Foundation and carried it proudly beyond her 96th birthday. In December 2007, she left us to be at Field's side once again. But the legacy of the foundation remains. And just like they planned, it will continue to make an impact on young people's lives for generations to come.